Welcome for part two of the series of videos about sketchbook creating. Today we are going to bind the sketchbook together and you will have your own piece of sketchbook made by yourself. If you missed the first part, just click a bit out there to get the previous video. And let's keep going on the sketchbook making. So now we are going to put some marks and to prepare the hole for the binding. For the holes for the binding, you can choose how many holes you want. I usually go for 5, I think that's not bad. So I have to make the same measuring that the piece of sketchbook I am currently working on. So my pro tips number, I think that's number 5, is rather than measuring the whole length and getting a bit confused sometimes about how you are going to divide it or something to get even, the tips is to start by the two outside holes. So in my sketchbook I put mine at 1.5 centimeters, so just have to put the marks at the same distance from the sides of the sketchbook. And usually, you know, you try to be a bit clever with your measuring so that you have a bit of an even number in the middle. So I have 16 centimeters in the middle, and as I'm going to add 3 holes, it will be 4 areas. So in fact I just have to put a mark every 4 centimeters. You can do how we did earlier by dividing by 2 or 2 or something. You can even put the ruler in the middle of the page. Try to find a number that is easily divided by, let's say, by 4 like I did, and then you can just put the outside holes and you divide the other number by 4. I hope the explanation are not too confusing. That's always easier to do things than to explain them. Trying to do my best, but sometimes, of course, you do the same measuring on each signature. And that's okay. So now, for the holes, you can use a needle, you can use some pin like this, or you can use, like me, this kind of tool, which has a point. It's a bit easier to handle that the pin is so small. And then I usually just put a sort of random piece of cardboard underneath the sketchbook, but can have a sort of big surface to work on. I don't know if it's really useful, but usually when I make my holes, I try to hold the sketchbook a bit like that, folding it, hoping that it will be an easier way so that all the holes are aligned in the fold. Yeah, that's how I do it. Just put your paper together before doing it, and then just create your holes so that it will be easy to sew. Here it is, and the other one. So, almost ready to bind these together. That's so exciting! I'm almost sketchbook ready. For the binding, one of my favorite pro tips that I invented is using small small bulldog clips to hold the sketchbook together. So we are going to put the needle in the middle of the sketchbook to make the thread going out and in the sketchbook, and for the other pieces too, so that we can sew both together. So we are going to use the bulldog clips to hold this kind of middle part together. So you open each signature by the middle and put your bulldog clips, small ones, just at the base. And I can tell you how a tremendous help it is, so that it's really, really easy like that to sew. Hey! So by the way, this binding technique is meant to put two signatures together, like I am doing right now, so I hope it will be useful for you. So for the sewing you need a needle, of course, and a thread. As for me, I'm going to use this kind of twine so that you can see a bit more what I am doing. For the length of the thread, you need about twice, you know, the distance. And a bit more, you can say twice and a half or three times, a bit like that. So, putting the thread in the needle. So, you want the tail to be outside the sketchbook so that it's it doesn't show inside. My next pro tip is don't make a knot at the end of the thread. You will see how it goes at the end and why I recommend not to make a knot. But yeah, do it and you'll see how it goes. So just start sewing the sketchbook by the outside. And keep a bit of a tail at the end. Then, inside the signature, move forward and go out again. Now, each time the thread is out of the sketchbook, you cross between the two and you pick on in the other one. Then you pull out the needle in the other sketchbook, then move forward in this signature, pull the thread out, then cross between the two signatures, then keep moving forward in this signature. That's normal that there is a sort of gap here between the two. You are out of the sketchbook again, cross and change between the two signatures, and your needle is going to end up the other side. Then move forward in this signature and you end up outside again. Cross between the two signatures. Pull the thread. And then we're going to, you know, go the other way. So move backward in this signature. Pull the thread. Cross. Can see that in the crossing you have two threads out there, that's normal. You end up in the other signature. Move backwards. Cross. Move backwards. Cross. The bulldog clips are handy so that you can, you know, go quickly between one side and one other side. Move backward one last time. And that's it. You end up at the beginning of the sketchbook near the other thread. And I am sure you know what I'm going to do. Now that I have these two tails together, I just have to make a knot and that's it. I usually use my knee, you know, to put this big piece between my knees sometimes when I am sewing. So this time I didn't do that to show you things a bit better. So you can remove the needle and just try to pull the thread quite well. So that, you know, it's nicely and tight. not too hard, not to break it if it's a thin one. Sometimes if you have a thin thread, you can use, you know, both threads together and just make one knot and another one, or several ones, to be sure it's tight. And nice, here it is. So I usually keep a bit of the tails for two reasons. One reason is because it make a bit of you know, the do-it-yourself thing appear, and I like it. And the other reason is if you keep a bit of the tail and it's unraveled, you can always knot it again if you have a bit of tail. But if it's cut really, really short, it's it's more difficult to do, and you have to make the binding again. So here it is. You just have to remove the clips. That's it, you have your piece of sketchbook, your two signatures together. It's already quite a nice thick thing to work on. Nice homemade sketchbook, gorgeous paper, just the size I like. Nice binding, and if you try to do it quite tight when you open it, it still have a bit of a little gap between the two, but not too much. If you want more content about sketchbooking, journaling, you know, creating the sketchbooks, but also filling them and working on them and sketching, journaling and everything and other creative stuff, feel free to subscribe. Thanks for following me and have a good creative day. Thank you.